Good morning and welcome to worship this wonderful sunny spring morning. We can really see our stained glass on a day like today, which is such a blessing. Our worship leaders today are, of course, Pastor Lily Brondike, worship musicians Kim and John Beck. Our live stream is Kyra Beck. Our head of ushers is Rodney Spence. Altar Guild is Mary Anderson and Jean Sobey. The radio broadcast this morning is to the glory of God and in celebration of Alexandra and Taylor's wedding on April 20th by Marla Mimi Gossin. Altar flowers this morning are to the glory of God and in celebration of those that we welcome to the table today. Welcome.
Good morning, everybody. And welcome to Bethany Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Lily Brondike, and I am the pastor here. And it is a joy to worship with you this morning, whether you be here in our sanctuary or tuning in over our Facebook live stream, welcome, or our radio broadcast. It is a gift to be the body of Christ throughout time and space. On this, the fourth Sunday in the Easter season, our season of celebrating the life and joy and resurrection given to us through Jesus Christ. Today is another full day at Bethany. Today we welcome three new students to the table. These students and their parents have taken a class teaching them about communion, teaching them about the grace given to us in the body and blood, the bread and wine that we receive at this rail every week in church. They'll come back from Sunday school and we'll celebrate them with this meal, like we celebrate every week the gift that is this grace. Now, from whatever kind of weeks you've had, you've been drawn here. We have been drawn together into one body in Christ for worship this morning. I invite you to take a deep breath and center yourselves. And when you're ready, rise as we begin worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity. One God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter, and our joy.
Amen.
Look, here is water.
Here is our water of life.
Immersed in the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep, and water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom's land. In a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water. At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you through the risen Christ, our source of living water, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Look, here is water. Alleluia.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the help save, comfort, and defend us, gracious.
us pray together. O Lord Christ, good shepherd of the sheep, you seek the lost and guide us into your fold. Feed us and we shall be satisfied. Heal us and we shall be whole. Make us one with you, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The first reading this morning is from Acts. The next day, the rulers, elders, and scribes assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, and Alexander, and all who were of high priestly family. When they had made the prisoners stand in their midst, they inquired, "By what power or by what name did you do this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are questioned today because of one good deed done to someone who was sick, and are asked how this man has been healed, let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that this man is standing before you in good health by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders. It has become the cornerstone. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among mortals by which we must be saved." The word of the Lord. Second reading this morning is from 1 John. We know love by this, that Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need and yet refuses help? Little children, let us love, not in word or speech, but in truth and action. And by this, we will know that we are from the truth and will reassure our hearts before him whenever our hearts condemn us. For God is greater than our hearts and he knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have boldness before God and we receive from him whatever we ask because we obey his commandments and do what he pleases. And this is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he has commanded us. All who obey his commandments abide in him, and he abides in them. And by this we know that he abides in us, by the Spirit that he has given us, the word of the Lord.
Please rise as we welcome the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
you may be seated. I want to give a little bit of a heads up with today's sermon. I'm going to talk today about the realities of suicide in our country. And I want you to know that I won't be sharing any stories or details about any events. I won't be naming specific instances. And I talk about this subject that's so hard from an informed and trained place where my goal is safety and compassion. But I am going to name suicide this morning. And if at any point you need to excuse yourself, please do not hesitate. We have a place set up downstairs each Sunday where worship is live streaming, and you can take a seat and just take a breath, or you can step outside for some fresh air. My goal in preaching is to always proclaim the good news of the risen Christ for you and for all the world, and perhaps today, that good news might look like taking a break and taking care of yourselves. And always know that anyone at any time can find themselves in a moment of crisis. And if you find yourself in crisis, or someone you love finds themselves in crisis, you can call or text 988 to reach the Suicide and Crisis Lifeline here in the United States. In 2021, the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention estimates that 1.7 million suicide attempts were made in our country. 48,183 Americans died by suicide in 2021. Suicide is the 11th leading cause of death in the United States. White males accounted for 70% of suicide deaths in 2021. In today's gospel story, we hear a story including a wolf, the wolf that comes for the sheep of a flock. And it's not just any flock. This flock belongs to Jesus, the good shepherd who lays down his life for the flock, the good shepherd who knows his own sheep, who promises to bring all into his one flock. And yet, for all that the good shepherd does, the wolf still comes for the flock. In our psalm, we heard that the Lord is our shepherd, and that this Lord will be with us always, but that we will still find ourselves walking through the valley of the shadow of death. Jesus is our good shepherd, and our lives will still be filled with death and grief and maybe even moments of total despair and desperation. Perhaps there will even be moments when the desperation of that despair overwhelms the resiliency of life and hope. Our synod, the Northern Great Lakes Synod, this network that we belong to of other Lutheran churches like ours in the Upper Peninsula and the upper crust of Wisconsin, our synod sponsored a faith-based suicide prevention training at Fortune Lake Lutheran Camp. And there's a statistic from this workshop that continues to rattle me. In any given Christian community on a Sunday morning, research would tell us that 1 in 2 people are affected by suicide. This means that 1 in every 2 people in our pews have had someone close to them die by suicide, have walked with someone through their own suicidal ideation, have supported kids in their community through a suicide, or have themselves experienced suicidal ideation or suicide attempts. This number is overwhelming. And I believe that this number carries a multitude of messages for us this morning. But the one I want to hone in on is this: you are not alone. Though you walk through your own valley of shadow and death, you are not alone. Though the wolf comes and tries to make you feel as though somehow you could be separated from this flock, as though you aren't good enough for this flock, as though you should be ashamed of exactly who God creates you to be, you are not alone. 1 in 2. Look around. There's a lot of shame and stigma that surrounds the topics of suicide, mental health, and death. The reality is that 50% of us struggle with suicide and suicidal ideation in the ways it impacts our lives, our communities, our families, and our friends. Shame convinces us that we are alone in this. Shame convinces us that we must handle these huge things on our own. Shame would have us believe that we are not worthy of support or care or compassion because we are not good enough, that somehow we are weak. Shame tells us that our problems are our own fault and that the solutions, thus, are ours to carry alone. Shame is a powerful force in our world. It's a familiar valley that we all have walked through, and it is a wolf that constantly seeks to separate sheep from the flock, convincing them that no one cares. But, here is the good news. The opposite of shame is connection. It's community. Jesus is our good shepherd, and because of who Jesus is, because of what Jesus has done, we have all been transformed. We are the flock. I am the flock. You are the flock. Through Jesus Christ, our identity has become a communal one. Through Jesus Christ, the shame of our world is combated through connection and belonging in the body of Christ. We are connected as a community in the body of Christ, the body of Jesus, our good shepherd, the good shepherd that would never abandon his sheep. Jesus, the good shepherd, who will not abandon your side as you walk through the darkest valleys. Jesus, who will not leave you to fend off wolves on your own. If Jesus is our good shepherd, it means that the welcome to this flock has already been given. It means that belonging is already here. You are welcomed into the body of Christ exactly as God creates you to be in this world. There are no barriers to belonging in Christ. There's no race, there's no socioeconomic status, there's no diagnosis, there's no sexual or gender identity, there's no criminal record, there's no sin, there's no level of desperation, no number of suicide attempts that could keep you from belonging to this flock. It is the fourth Sunday of the Easter season, and yet again we practice living into the promise of hope and life that has been given to us through the death and resurrection of Jesus. We celebrate that the worst things we experience in this world are not the last things. We celebrate and share the promise that the worst moments of our lives, the most desperate and scary moments, are not our final moments, and we never walk through them alone. No one walks through these moments alone. Jesus is our good shepherd. Jesus is the good shepherd who does not abandon his sheep. And the good news is that there is always a tomorrow, that there is a sunrise that promises new beginnings, a sunrise that promises the forgiveness of yesterday's wrongs and orients us towards the hope of tomorrow. We are the church. We are the flock. We work toward and point to the healing Jesus' resurrection offers this world, healing that promises community over shame, life over death, and a resilient kind of hope that combats the most despairing of our desperations. Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. So know your belonging." We gather Sunday mornings to practice this very kind of belonging. In just a few moments, we're going to welcome three of our students raised in this congregation, attending Sunday school, taking classes here with their parents, to the table where Christ offers us week after week a sign of grace and a promise of hope for tomorrow. In the bread and wine, we practice belonging to that one body in Christ. We are all members of that one body, the oneness. That means that we are never alone, that Christ is constantly combating what shame can do to our sense of community and belonging. Your life here, practicing this community, your life as you leave, bearing the message of this belonging and welcome, bears witness to all that Christ can do. Your life is a witness to the flock that Jesus welcomes us all into. And that witness, here in this place and out there, saves lives. Alleluia.
Gathered with the whole church on earth, we confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. Shepherding God, gather your church whenever we wander from you and from one another. Empower our church and ministries around the world to worship and serve alongside global companions as equal partners and co-workers in the gospel. God of grace. Amen. Nurturing God, preserve the health of biomes and ecosystems. Inspire scientists, researchers, conservation organizations, and all people entrusted with the task of caring for creation, that we may be better stewards of the world around us. God of grace. Amen. Almighty God, lead nations and communities to share resources and to cooperate in solving conflicts and listen to the wisdom of indigenous peoples. Help all those with power to share it and use such power for good. God of grace. Loving God, protect the very young and the very old, those living without housing, victims of domestic abuse, and all who live with chronic illness, disabilities, or compromised immune systems. Guide communities to actively care for people who are vulnerable. We pray especially today for Priscilla Anderson, Pastor Dean Peterson, Roy Hibla, Lynn Leibel, Terry DePlante, Bert Zinker, Jim Lancor, Bob Pulowski, Lloyd Jensen, Kristen Farrell, Chris Lund, and those we name before you now, either aloud or at this moment of silence. God of grace. Gracious God, help this and all communities of faith to listen for your voice. Call us away from things that distract us from following you. Invite us to more deeply love and serve people who are lonely, isolated, and on the margins. God of grace. Living God, we give thanks for our ancestors in faith. Strengthen us to share the good news in our own day. God of grace. Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord.
Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share signs of that peace with one another.
Thank you.
risen one, you call us to believe and bear fruit. May the gifts that we offer here be signs of your abiding love. Form us to be your witnesses in the world through Jesus Christ, our true vine. Amen.
The Lord be with you. That we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Today we celebrate with Camden, Harper, Kelsey, and their families. These students have taken our class on the sacrament of Holy Communion. We gather around them as the body of Christ as they celebrate with us at this, the Lord's table. Jesus showed God's love in many ways. Forgiving sinners. Teaching God's love. Jesus was friends with people who were hated, made fun of, and treated badly. One of the ways Jesus showed love was by sharing food. We remember Bible stories about Jesus sharing meals. Jesus invited himself to eat with Zacchaeus at his house. Zacchaeus was surprised at Jesus' loving acceptance. Jesus fed thousands of people on the hillside with only a little bread and fish. There was plenty to go around after he blessed and broke the bread. Everyone was surprised at Jesus' generosity. Jesus gathered his friends for a meal we called the Last Supper. He picked up the bread, gave thanks to God, broke it, and shared it with them, saying, "Whenever you share this bread and cup, I will be with you, feeding you, loving you, forgiving you." Jesus' friends were surprised at his open-hearted love. Holy Communion is a gift for all people, and we celebrate it today. In this special meal, Jesus is with us, feeding us, loving us, forgiving us, and asking us to do the same for the people around us and around the world. Let us welcome our friends, Camden, Harper, and Kelsey, to Holy Communion. Welcome to Jesus' table. We rejoice with you and thank God for you. Enjoy this meal that strengthens all of us to live as Jesus did.
and gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us all pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You can all sit down. Here at Bethany Lutheran, we believe, and we have taught our students to believe, that Jesus has prepared a place for everyone at this, the Lord's table. Wherever you may be on your spiritual journey, if you have taken a communion class years ago, or you just took one a few weeks ago, or you've never taken one, you are most welcome to receive communion at this table, this gift of grace. Today, the ushers will invite the families of those who have taken this class to come on up to the communion rail first, where they will receive communion with their students. And then the ushers will dismiss the rest of you down the center aisle, where you are welcome to come and stand or kneel at our communion rail. If this is not accessible to you, please let our ushers know, and we will bring communion to you. The outer rings of this tray are filled with cups of wine. In the center, there is a lighter, non-alcoholic apple juice option. Gluten-free wafers are available. Please just let me know if you need those. The risen Christ is made known to us in the breaking of the bread. Come and eat at God's table.
and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Let us pray. Shepherding God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. At this time, I would like any kids worshiping with us to come on forward. I have a story today. Come on up, friends. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And take a seat right up here. It's so good to see all of you. Welcome. Raise your hand if you went to Sunday school today. Awesome. How was Sunday school today?
Good.
What did you do?
We make a sheep.
You make sheep? Why did you make sheep? Yes, Julia.
To show that Jesus is a good shepherd.
Oh, Jesus is a good shepherd. Throw out some things. What makes Jesus a good shepherd?
He looks after his sheep.
Jesus looks after his sheep. Awesome. Yeah. Yes, Jesus protects his sheep from the wolves. Beautiful. Yes, gives himself for everyone. Jesus is all of these things, and Jesus is a very good shepherd. And today, we celebrated with some of our friends up here one way that Jesus is a good shepherd. Raise your hand if you took a Welcome to the Table class on communion recently and came up with your families today. Yeah. And so today we celebrated with some of our friends over here that Jesus welcomes everyone to Jesus's table. And I have a little story that helps. So we're going to kind of have to circle around, though. Oh, my goodness. I'm stepping on my stool. Okay. Circle around here. It's a little book. It's a little book with a big welcome. So story time rules. We sit and keep our hands to ourselves, right, during story time? They stay in our own circle? All right. During story time, if we respect each other's circles, all is well. Okay, so we're learning about how Jesus is a good shepherd and welcomes everyone. So this book is called A Place for You. God sent Jesus to show that God loves everyone. Now, who's all in Jesus's hands?
Everybody
is in Jesus' arms. Jesus showed God's love in many ways. He told people that blessed are the poor, and he said, let little children come to me.
I can't see.
And he said, you are made well. Can everyone see that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Jesus also showed God's love by eating with people. What kind of people do we eat with? Yeah. Our families, our friends. Do we eat meals at church sometimes? Yeah, what were you going to say?
I was going to say that sometimes when I go to Owen's house, I eat with his family and
yes.
We eat pizza.
Yes, that's a great example. So Jesus is eating people as a way of Jesus is eating with people to show God's love for all people. Ooh, that was an important connector word.
With people.
One day, Jesus fed over 5,000 people. All the people knew that Jesus loved everybody. Look at all of those people. That's so many people. Oops. On the night before he died, Jesus and his friends gathered for a very special meal. And Jesus says, whenever you share this bread and cup, I will be with you, feeding you, loving you, forgiving you.
Even.
Ooh. Jesus died on a cross. On Easter morning, God raised Jesus from death to life. And we say, Alleluia, he is risen. The living Jesus went to his friends. He promised to be with them in the special meal. Then Jesus left them and returned to God. His friends met for the special meal. They ate the bread and drank from the cup. Then they carried extra bread to the sick and hungry. we also meet for the special meal of Jesus called Holy Communion. Does that sound familiar?
Yes.
Yes. There's a place for you. You can eat the bread, you can drink the cup, and after the meal, Jesus will go with you into the world. He will help you to love all people. With Jesus, we dream of a day when all will be fed and all will know that God loves who?
Everybody.
Everybody. And so every week in church, we practice this and we celebrate that God loves
everybody.
Yes, and I want you to remember that today, that when we gather here on Sunday mornings, we do so God can help us go back out into the world to help everybody know that God loves them. God gives us the strength to help people, to love people just like Jesus does. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Awesome. Thank you, friends, so much for coming up. You can head back to your seats with your families, and I hope you have an awesome week. Yes. Yeah. Who created God? That's an amazing question. All we know is that God was just always there. Isn't that wild? Yeah, it's wild. All right. There is stuff going on at Bethany. And they are. We are always in need of worship helpers. Ushers are the most important role every Sunday morning. They're the people who are greeting, who are practicing this welcome we know to be a part of who God is for the whole body of Christ. And we also have a pretty hard time finding ushers. So if you are interested in being an usher, we will teach you how to do it. All you need to do is let us know that you want to be an usher. There is a sign-up sheet in the back and an electronic sign-up sheet that you can access via this QR code, or you can tap into your Monday messenger that will be emailed to you each Monday. If we don't have your email address, leave it with us and we'll get you that sign-up sheet. We have a new member class coming up that is open to everybody, but if you know someone who has been thinking about joining our community in a more official way, where we get your email address, have them come to this class. We talk about the history of this community here at Bethany. We talk about all the ways you can get involved and what we're trying to do as the body of Christ in this time and in this place. And not next Sunday, but the Sunday after, we are having a church breakfast. So get to church a little bit early, 9 a.m., to grab a bite to eat. It is the most important meal of the day. There are other things going on, so be sure to tune into our Monday Messenger, our weekly newsletter, the bulletin board in the back, our website, bethanyescanaba.org, to stay in tune to what is happening here at Bethany. One more quick announcement. You'll notice that there are other hymnals or worship books in your pews this morning. Over the next couple weeks, you'll see some extra information in your bulletin. These worship books were given to us at a really great price from our friends at Salem Lutheran in Bark River. And so we got these hymnals. They allow us to sing a lot more songs, to look at a lot of different liturgy without needing to print everything. So pay attention to your bulletins in the upcoming weeks. We'll be adding information that'll help you navigate that worship book. So we have heard the word, the good news of Christ proclaimed. We have received grace and forgiveness at the table in the bread and wine, and we have heard that God's welcome is indeed for everybody. And now we go out into the world to share that with everyone who needs to hear it. So I invite you to rise and to receive this blessing. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope bless you now and always.
Strangers turn to friends.
Rejoice and be glad.